Welcome to section 1 of chapter 5. This section is entitled Mid-Segment Theorem and Coordinate Proof. So we're going to be learning about two things in this video. One, we're going to learn about mid-segments, and then we're also going to do coordinate proofs. Now, don't think these proofs are not like the proofs we did in past chapters. So this is not a two-column proof. This is something different. You should be on page 19 in your packet, please. So first thing we should probably talk about is, what is a mid-segment? Well, a mid-segment connects two sides, a mid-segment connects two sides' midpoints. Sorry, I don't know if that's grammatically correct. So let's look at an example. So if we have a triangle, there's three midpoints. Remember, a midpoint bisects the segment, so I need to show that. So this right here is a mid-segment. It connects two midpoints. This one is also going to be a mid-segment. It connects two midpoints. This one is also going to be a mid-segment because it connects two midpoints. So to the right, we see that every triangle has three mid-segments. The mid-segment has two very important properties. It is parallel to the base, and it's half the length of the base. So if this was our segment AB and this was the base DF, so we know that AB would be parallel to DF. And we know that AB is going to be half the length of whatever DF is. So DF is 20, then AB is going to be 10. So let's look at example 1. It says AB is 10. What's DF? Well, AB is half of whatever DF is. DF is going to be bigger, so if I multiply 10 by 2, I get 20. Okay, now I have, if EF is 33, find AC. Okay, the mid-segment is half of the base. So I'm going to take half of 33, which is 33 over 2, or 16.5. Either one of those. Okay, if BC is 7, BC is 7, find BF. Okay, this one we can't do. So I'm sorry, that must have been my mistake. Right now, pause the video and try these two on your own, please. So it's similar to the first two bullet points, but pause it and try these two on your own. Okay, you should have had a chance to try these on your own. Let's see how we did. If DA is 13, find BC. Okay, well, we know that point A is a midpoint. So if DA is 13, that means AE is 13, which means the entire side is 26. BC then is going to be half of 26, which is 13 again. Okay, and then I said the perimeter of triangle DEF of the big triangle is 40. What's the perimeter of the little triangle? Well, all of the mid-segments are half of the bases, so I'm going to have to take half of 40, which is 20. Okay, so hopefully we got that one right. If not, that's okay. Hopefully we now see what mistakes we made. So now we're going to continue with these properties, but we're going to add in some algebra. So let's look at example 2. It says, consider triangle DEF with midpoints A, B, and C. Okay, when it tells you this, all that means is this A, B, B, C, and A, C, that these are mid-segments. That's what the problem is trying to tell us. So it says, in the figure, AC is 3x add 4. And EF is 8x subtract 20. Find the length of AC. Okay, well, I could find AC if I knew what X was. So really, I have to start by finding X. What's really tempting is to set 3x plus 4 equal to 8x minus 20. Okay, well, let's think logically. Does it look like this segment is equal to this segment? That should not look to be true, so you can't do that. You have to remember that the mid segment is half of whatever the base is. So in this case, our mid segment is 3x add 4. That's going to be half of the base, which is 8x subtract 20. Okay, so if I distribute the 1 half, I still have the 3x plus 4. Half of 8x is going to be 4x, and then half of 20 is going to be 10. Okay, I have to subtract 3x, which leaves me with x. I have to add 10, which leaves me with 14. So I get x equals 14. But then I have to remember that that's not my final answer. The question says, find the length of AC. So I still have to substitute that back in. I have AC is equal to 3x add 4. So that's 3 multiplied by 14 add 4, which is 46 units. Okay, so let's look at it. This is yours to try. It's very similar. Mark the figure, and then try this one on your own. This right here should be DF, not DE. So if you could fix that. Pause the video, try this one on your own, please. Okay, so we should have had AB is 3x minus 3. DF, because I had to fix this one, is 5x. So we should have had 3x minus 3. The mid segment is half of the base, so it's half of 5x. So I get 3x minus 3 is 2.5x. If I subtract 3x, I get negative 3 equals negative 0.5x, which gives me x equals 6. Okay, but then we are asked to find the length of DC. So if I substitute 6 in to DF, I get 30, which means these two parts are 15 and 15, because remember, C is the midpoint. So in the end, I get DC equals 15 units. Hopefully you got that one right. If not, hopefully you now see what mistake you made. So that was the mid segment. Now we have to do the coordinate proof, and then we are finished. Okay, so coordinate proofs have to do with shapes in the coordinate plane. So looking at example 4, it says place a rectangle in the coordinate plane and assign coordinates to each vertex. So all that means is I have to draw in a rectangle. Okay, that's a rectangle, and then assign coordinates to the vertices. So this is 0, 0, this is 6, 0, this is 6, 3, and this one is 0, 3. And that's it. That's a coordinate proof. Right now, pause the video and put a second rectangle in example 4, and then try example 5. So you have two that you need to do. Put a different rectangle in example 4, and then put a scalene triangle in example 5, and then come back when you are finished, please. Okay, you should have had enough time to try this one. So if I were going to put another rectangle in, I might do this rectangle right here. Or you could have had a rectangle out here. But any other rectangle, and then a scalene triangle. Okay, scalene triangle, that means the three sides are all different. So, I could draw a triangle like this. I can tell that the three sides are different. I could draw something like this. Again, I can tell that the three sides are different. But you should have drawn a triangle so that you could see that the three sides are different. Here, you should notice the first triangle I drew in. This is a right triangle also. So it's right and then scalene. Okay, but see, that was a coordinate proof. I know some of you hear the word proof and automatically think of doom, but that's not too bad. So that's this section. We found some mid-segments, the lengths. Now, by using the fact that the mid-segment is half of the base, and then we drew some coordinate proofs. Okay, so right now what you need to do is you need to go to page 14 in your packet and do example number 12. This will be your exit slip to class tomorrow. So page 14 in your packet and do example 12. It has to do with mid-segments. When you come to class tomorrow, I'm going to be checking to make sure that you have this problem completed. Good luck!